scoring above 13, and but not higher like the price was here in beginning of March or end of March. We had reached the last time $17. So it's called, if I do this with an option strategy, it's called debit call spread. I buy a $13 option and I sell a $17 options. And with these two strike prices, I will tell you now exactly what is your chance and risk profile. And we will do the same if you want to trade it like a little bit more, I would like to say conservative or like not so aggressive. We can also do the same where we say, for example, the price of American Airline will not drop below $9. And just to make sure if there's a big change or a big fall in the price of American Airline, we will have a, I call it airbag at $7 that we don't lose too much. That's called credit spread. In this case, credit put spread. You can already see here the two prices, $9 and $7. Even it's not exactly this price in our horizontal lines. It just I just put it to explain you the details. Okay, let's go to what we said, how to set up this strategy and how to calculate the correct chance risk profile, chance risk analysis. The first example, what we said is I expect a price increasement above $13 and maximum will be 17. So I create an option strategy here. I will put it July, so it's 46 days till expiration. So I buy the call for $13 and I will sell it on $17. So here, I don't know if you can read it, it's a bull spread. So actually a debit call spread, what is also called bull spread. And the Trader Workstation will always show you the chance risk profile. So for example, we have maximum loss of 1 second of $65 and maximum return of $335. And then you just have to set this so that you can calculate it like from 1 to 4. It will be exactly, not exactly, but approximately if your risk is we can get a price maybe a bit cheaper, $60, you will gain $340. So it's $6 to 240. So it's actually something like 1 to 5, 1 to 6. So it's a very good chance risk profile. And how can we calculate this? So how from where we got these numbers? It's normally pretty easy because your maximum profit is always the difference between the two strike prices. So if you calculate 17 multiplied minus 13, you have a maximum profit of $4. And this 340 is multiplied by 100. So you just have to minus it with the debit you have to invest for the spread. That's why it's called debit spread. We have to invest something. And the investment at the moment, you can see the bid price is 3 cents and the ask price is 65. That's why I said we normally get a better execution, what will be 60 cents. So our maximum profit is difference between two strike prices, what is $4 minus 60 cents. So we have $340 maximum profit. And our maximum loss is only what we invested here in the debit spread. So it's a very good chance risk ratio. The only thing is, if it's not going up to minimum $13, you will lose your whole investment, in this case, the 60 cents. And if I say 60 cents, I think, as I said it earlier, it's always multiplied by 100 because one option is equal to 100 shares. So everything what you see here as a price is multiplied by 100 if you do it in a real position. So I think this is pretty easy, pretty simple. It's a good chance risk profile, and it makes you easily calculate what's the maximum you can lose, because as we told you earlier, if I buy 100 shares of American Airlines, in theory, I can lose everything what I invested if American Airlines going bankrupt. But if with my debit spread, it's just the 60 cents, $60. So the risk is really lower. Profit, depending if American Airlines will go up to $20, I will not have a bigger profit than in my equity position. And you have to calculate also the time value, what is related to the expiration date of July. So like I said in the beginning, there's always an advantage and a disadvantage, what makes it good for comparing which strategies might be better for you if you're just a normal stock trader. We will see the last point with covered call and put writing, what might be also bringing a benefit to your normal stock portfolio. And for the profile, you can exactly normally see, let's selected July. So you can see which price and which is your profit and loss with the date here selected. For the last day, it will be easy. My maximum loss will be as long as the price is not reaching this $13, my strike price. And my break-even is also easy to calculate. It's always the strike price plus your debit what you paid. So we just need to make sure that the price is on the last day of the expiration on minimum strike price of my long position plus the premium I paid or the debit I paid. In this example, it's 60 cents. So everything above $13.60 will generate a profit. The earlier it will reach this, the earlier I will go also in profit, or can even close the position with a profit because hold it till the expiration date. It's just the last day where you can trade this, and then there will be expiration or option assignment where you get the stocks which you had the right to buy for a certain strike price here. And the opposite, the credit spread, just to make this example on the other hand side, this was debit spread. And the last thing I want to show you was credit spread with the $9 and what else did we say? Seven. So in this case, it's a debit credit put spread where we say the price will not drop under nine. We are selling this option, and just for safety reasons, we will buy the $7 put. So for this, I will get a credit because now it's a credit spread. I'm selling first an option, what is the put option for $9, and I buy the put option for $7 just in case it will drop like below seven. I don't lose more than this difference between these two strike prices. The same example, just the opposite what we did in the debit spread. Now my maximum risk is the difference between two strike prices. So nine minus seven is two, and I get a credit for this, what is actually 50 cents. So I deducted this 50 cents from my maximum loss. So my maximum loss in any case, even American Airlines is going down to $1 to zero, whatever, I can only lose $1.50. So my chance risk ratio is 1 to 3 because for getting $1, I have to risk $3. But only if it's really going that low that it's below $7. And from the probability side, credit spreads or in general, 75% of all options are expiring with any value. So with credit spreads, you might have a really high probability to get like a positive trade with some income. And that's normally a good way to have like really a secured position where you can wait till the end of the expiration date. As long as it's above $9, nothing will happen. And for you, it doesn't matter. Now the price is at 11. It can go down to 10. You will still have your same credit. It will go down to 9.50. You still have 100% of your credit. And this is here the chance risk performance graph, the same what we had earlier for the debit spread. You can also select here different times to see how the time value, for example, will change in this graph. But mainly the line with the dots, it's how it's changing if the price changes today. And the other one is like the last day of the expiration. And here you see exactly what I was telling you. They put 45 cents because they normally always choose the bid price. So we get a little bit better entry price. It's $50 and maximum loss is 150. So 1 to 3 is our chance risk ratio. And yeah, it makes it also very easy. You can also see some profit and loss numbers here in the screen below. So it will give you normally all the information if you set up a strategy order here in the option trader. And here's what I told you, the middle price, yeah, maybe $48 is 48 cents, what we will get for this. So mainly this was a very short overview about debit credit spreads and chance risk ratio. Another thing what I want to show you is open interest and implied volatility. I told you the implied volatility, I hope you can see it here with my my mouse. It's 100% for, here you can see it, implied volatility 100%. So it means because the stock was moving crazy the last days, it went up 10% and it went down 7% another day. So this is what makes the options, the price for the options a little bit more expensive. And normally if you have a very high implied volatility, you normally select like normal credit spreads to collect credits to get a premium. And if the implied volatility is below 50, or sometimes you will find it also with some it's below 40, it's better to select debit spreads or to be on the long position side where you buy options. Because from a high price, always if you sell it, you will participate from a higher price. And if it's considered as cheap, you should be on the buy side. So implied volatility, it's also information what you find here in your option trader. And open interest is this field what we see here, and it will help you to understand